Can't believe how I have fallen for Oh. Hughes. Thank you. Κυρίλε, Κύριε, είναι Μεσοποταμία, στενωμένο νυφέστα στα του κυρίου αυτού, Ισά γενέκα, και διαμυστηρίες γεδρέφερος. Αναγνήσασε την Ραβέκα να προκαλούσας, αυτός ευλόγησε τον αναγνώμα του Δούλου.
Ευλογημένη Βασιλεία Πατρός και του Υιού και το Άγιο Πνεύματος, νίκια ή και εις τους αιώνας των αιώνων. Αμήν. Χριστός Ανέστη εκ νεκρών, θανάτω,
Father, the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
be honored, O bridegroom, like Abraham, and be blessed like Isaac, a multiply like Jacob, walking in peace and doing in righteousness the commandments of God. And you, bride, be honored like Sarah, rejoice like Rebecca, and be fruitful like Rachel, rejoicing in your husband and fulfilling the conditions of the law. For this is what has pleased God. Let us pray to the Lord. O Lord our God, who came to Cana of Galilee and blessed the marriage there, bless also these your servants, who through your providence were joined in the fellowship of marriage. Bless their comings and goings, and fill their life with all that is good. Receive their crowns into your kingdom, unsoiled and undefiled, and preserve them without offense to the ages of ages. Peace be unto all. Bow your heads unto the Lord. May the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, the one holy and life-giving Trinity, the one Godhead and kingship, bless you. And grant you long life, good children, progress in life and in faith, fill with all the good things on earth, and make your ways enjoy the promised blessings as well, through the intercessions of the Holy Theotokos and of the Virgin Mary and of all the saints. Δόξα σοι ο Θεός εν πίσημον Κύριε δόξα σοι, που δια σαν κενά επιδημίας τίμων δείξει του γάμου, και να στάσει εκ νεκρό, Χριστός ο αληθινός θεσιμών, τις πρεσβείες πανάκτάντου και πανάμωμα υγιής αυτού μητρός. Ελεήσε και σώσει να αγαθώς του πλάντος και ελεήμων Θεός. Χριστός ανέστη εκ νεκρό, θανάτου θάνατον βάτησας, και θεν τη μνήμας η ζωή χαρισάμενο.
they can access our
Lord's Prayer?
Yes, kingdoms from heaven.
Thank you. They come here trusting in the love that they have for each other as they face the future yet to be discovered, unknown, yet experienced, and to be people who will pray for them and hold both Flora and Emmett in their hearts. And so before we hear from God's word, and before we celebrate their exchange of vows, let's bow our heads. May their lives always bear witness to the reality of that love. We ask this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. Amen.
The reading from the first letter of St. John. Beloved, let us love one another, because love is of God. Everyone who loves is begotten by God and knows God. Whoever is without love does not know God, for God is love. In this way, the love of God was revealed to us. God sent his only begotten Son into the world, so that we might have life through him. In this love, not that we have loved God, but that he has loved us, and sent his Son as expiation for our sins. Beloved, if God so loved us, we also must love one another. No one has ever seen God, yet if we love one another, God remains in us, and his love is brought to perfection in us. The word of the Lord.
The Lord is compassionate. The Lord is compassionate towards all his works. The Lord is compassionate toward all his works. The Lord is gracious and merciful, slow to anger and of great kindness. The Lord is good to all and compassionate toward all his works. The Lord is compassionate toward all his works. Let all your work give you thanks, O Lord, and let your faithful ones bless you. The eye of all look hopefully to you, and you give them their food in due season. The Lord is compassionate in all his works. The Lord is just in all his ways, and holy in all his works. The Lord is near to all who can upon him, to all who call upon him in truth. The Lord is compassionate toward all his works.
The Lord be with you. Reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Jesus said to his disciples, "This is my commandment, love one another as I love you. No one has greater love than this, than to lay one's life for one's friends. I have called you friends because I have told you everything I have heard from my Father. It was not you who first chose me, and so whatever you ask the Father in my name, he may give you." The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated for a moment. They're very plain words. They're not fancy. They're not profound as such. They're words that we use so constantly in our vocabulary, and so often we don't even hear ourselves say them. But these ordinary, simple words are going to bound both of you profoundly in a relationship in which you will both give unselfishly to each other, and that you will discover in this unselfish love that you are called to have something of the profound and the sacred moving within your relationship. These simple words are words that will have to be in flesh and have form and colour. They're words that have to be concrete and demonstrated. Words that will pursue you and haunt you. And as you go forward in your marriage, you will have to constantly, day by day, remember them. Because it will be day by day that your marriage is going to grow and to foster and to bear fruit. You're going to have to bear your marriage at a distance from your family and friends. You're not going to have the normal sense of support and comfort that most young married people have when they launch forth together from your family at a distance. with one that makes your hearts grow fonder, and in the absence, know that your family and friends. We live in a very commercialized world, one which is noted by status and look, in a world that so often is about having and getting. Our world tells us in its commercialism, one of the most important things that anyone can discover is the sacredness of their life, their integrity, their dignity, their uniqueness, as created in the image and the likeness of God. Life is sacred because what wells up within us is that sense of God's presence and God's love. Too profound, too mysterious, ethereal, so easily dances off our tongues, and we can scribble it without even being aware of the trace of the pen on the paper. But love is something that you'll have to discover. Your love today is not the love of tomorrow. It wasn't the love of yesterday. You'll have to learn what love is, and you'll have to learn how to give it to each other without cost, without a price tag, without demand, but altruistically, to be selfless in that.
Dora and Emmett, you have come together in this church of St. Dominic so that the Lord may seal and strengthen your love in the presence of me, the church's minister, and this community of your family and friends. Christ abundantly blesses your love. He has already consecrated you both in baptism, and now he enriches and strengthens you by a special sacrament so that you may assume the duties of marriage in mutual and lasting fidelity. And so, in the presence of the Church, I ask you to state your intentions. Emmett and Dora, have you come here freely and without reservation to give yourselves to each other in marriage? Will you love and honour each other as man and wife for the rest of your lives? And will you accept children lovingly from God and bring them up according to the law of Christ and his Church? And since it is your intention to enter into marriage, I ask you to join your hands together and to declare your consent. Excuse me.
Thank you. I am.
Take you, Dora.
To be my lawful wife.
To be my lawful wife.
To have and to hold. From this day forward. For better, for worse. For richer, for poorer. In sickness and in health. Until death do us part. Emmett?
Aye.
I, Dora.
Thank you, Emmett.
For my lawful husband. To have and to hold. From this day forward. For better, for worse. For richer, for poorer. In sickness and in health. Until death do I part.
You have declared your consent before the Church. May the Lord in his goodness strengthen your consent and fill you both with his blessings. What God has joined, no one must divide. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Please give them a round of applause. This is a piece of metal. Circular and probably quite expensive. Might take it home. Now, it doesn't hold any value at all except for the cost.
But what we're going to do in a few moments, these rings are going to be transformed to be symbols of the love of Dora and Emmett. They're going to be, first of all, reminders to each one of them of what they have just in a few seconds ago contracted. They're going to be signs to other people of their commitment. They're going to be for them, Dora and Emmett, a constant reminder of what yet is to be, not so much of what was. It's circular, it's eternal. We're going to pray that the eternal love of God rests with both Dora and Emmett in their lives, so that in touching that sacredness, they will be able to celebrate it with love and affection, with faith, with hope, and with love. Lord, bless these rings, which we bless in your name. Grant that Dora and Emmett, who wear them, may always have a deep faith in each other. May they do your will and always live together in peace, goodwill, and love. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Emmett, take this ring as a sign of my love
and fidelity.
In the name of the Father.
And of the Son.
And of the
Holy Spirit.
And of the Holy Spirit.
And Emmett, I, Dora, accept this ring.
Dora, I accept this ring.
As a sign of your love.
As a sign of your love.
And fidelity.
And fidelity.
Dora, take this ring.
Dora, take this ring.
As a sign of my love.
As a sign of my love.
And fidelity.
And fidelity.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
And of the Son.
And of the Son.
And of the Holy Spirit.
And of the Holy Spirit.
Emmett, I accept this ring.
Emmett, I accept this ring.
As a sign of your love.
As a sign of your love.
And fidelity.
And fidelity.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
And of the Son.
And of the Son.
And of the Holy Spirit.
And of the Holy Spirit.
And now Vicky is going to lead us in our prayers of the faithful. This hour of promise is also a time of prayer. Let us turn to God our Father and make our response by saying, Lord, have mercy. So together, Lord, have mercy.
For our church, to keep the promise of salvation, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For our world, to keep the promise of peace, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For our country, to keep the promise of freedom,
Lord, have mercy.
For our parish, to keep the promise of discipleship, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For our hearts, to keep the promise of loving, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For our hands, to keep the promise of loving, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For our lives, to keep the promise of loving, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For this couple, to keep the promise of loving,
Lord, have mercy.
Father, you have chosen us and given us your love in the power of the Holy Spirit. May our faith issue forth in action, our love show itself in deeds, and our hope give us courage. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
My dear friends, let us ask God for his continued blessings upon Emmett and Dora. Let us pray silently for them for a few moments.
Source of blessing for married life, we humbly pray for Dora, who today is united with Emmett in the sacrament of marriage. May your fullest blessings come upon them, so that they may together rejoice in your gift of married love and enrich your church with their children. May they be glad that you help them in their work and know that you are with them in their need. May they pray to you in the community of the church and be your witnesses in the world. May they reach old age in the company of their friends and come at last to the kingdom of heaven. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
Amen.
must remember this. A kiss is still a kiss. A sigh is just a sigh. The fundamental things apply as time goes by. And when two lovers woo, they still say I love you. On that you can rely. No matter what the future brings, as time goes by. And love songs are never out of date. Hearts full of passion, jealousy and hate. Woman needs man, and man must have his mate. That no one can deny. It's still the same old story, a fight for love and glory, a case of do or die.
It's amazing how you can speak right to my heart. Without saying a word, you can light up the dark. Try as I may, I can never explain what I hear when you don't say a thing. The smile on your face lets me know there's a truth in your eyes, saying you'll never leave me. The touch of your hand says you'll catch me wherever I fall. You say it best when you say nothing at all. All day long I can hear people talking out loud. But when you hold me near, you drown out the crowd. Try as they may, they can never define what's been said. Says you'll catch me wherever I fall. You say it best when you say nothing at at all.
Ladies and gentlemen, if I could kindly have your attention, please. My name is Emmanuel. I'm your MC for the night. I'm also part of the band Jarzane. I'd like to welcome you all here at the Langham Hotel in the celebration of the wedding reception of Emmett and Dora Kelly. I'd like you all please to remain seated until the bride and groom make their entrance. Thank you very much. And on that note, I'd like you all now please to give a round of applause for obviously the groom's parents. Please put your hands together for Mr. Daniel and Mrs. Sheila Kelly. Session, we have the bride's parents. A round of applause for Mr. Chris and Mrs. Marina Zekopoulos. The bridesmaid and the groomsmen, please put your hands together and make welcome John Peter Mansfield with Christine Zeptopoulos. And maid of honour, put your hands together please for Kevin Kelly and Annie Zeptopoulos. Ladies and gentlemen, I would kindly ask everybody please to be upstanding. It gives me great pleasure in inviting the most important couple of the evening, and of course that is the bride and groom. Come on, a rowdy round of applause for Mr. Emmett and Mrs. Dora Kelly. All right. And Dora, all the best. Nazisha in application. Cheers. And now the bride and groom may be seated. We'll sing along for their jolly good couple. For them a jolly good couple, for them a jolly good couple, for them a jolly good couple. And so say all of us, for them a jolly good couple, for them a jolly good couple, for them a jolly good couple. Hip hip. The last one but the loudest. Hip hip. All the best. Amen. Enjoy. Feliz Alexi. Bon appetit.
Thanks, Manuel.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Congratulations.
One more time for me, guys. It's getting close. Thank you.
invite the bride and groom onto the dance floor for their bridal waltz, ladies and gentlemen. So come on, give Emmett and Dora a round of applause.
Thank you. Thank you.
Come on, ladies and gentlemen, give him another round of applause. The Irish Pipers. Thank you very much. Ladies and gentlemen, while you're enjoying your main meals, we'd like to begin with the speeches. And I'd firstly like to pass the microphone over to the groom's father. Please give him a round of applause, Mr. Daniel Kelly.
Good evening, everybody. I hope everybody is enjoying themselves. Because by the time I'm finished, you'll be all walking out the door. First of all, I would like to say thank you all that come from New York, Greece, Florida, Ireland, and the lovely land of Australia. What do I say about this baby son that got married today? He's the youngest son of Sheila and my family of six. Four boys and two girls. Emmett is a hardworking son who has always been loving, caring, and sensible. On the Gaelic field, playing football in Ireland, he was always a team player, played with skill, he carried through in his working life, and got a scholarship to New York. Christopher and Marie and family, I look forward to the union of our families in every loving way, happy and caring way for a long, long time. To symbolize the union, I have been considering a concept. As you, Christos, have a garden center, and I have a family bakery business. All my life, and an obvious product union would be a cake or a break with a herb. Our flowers and ingredients. Anyone with any ideas, please come forward. And now, Dora, I must say you look radiant today. And I'm sure that the Australian and European values, both our families hold dear, will make for a wonderful reunion. I would like to ask you all to be upstanding for a toast. To Dora and Emmett, we wish you a long and graceful and happy and long marriage. And I finish up with an Irish Chia Míle Fáilte. A thousand thanks to you all. That's the meaning.
Thank you, Danny.
That's right.
And now we do have the best man, Kevin Kelly, to say a few words.
Well, I'd like to say that I had a speech ready before I came here, obviously.
You're bailing out.
I need my brother just to close down for a few seconds and let me talk for a while, because he usually likes to talk ahead of me. But after coming here and meeting everybody, the speech changed a little bit. Not too much, but it changed. Because after meeting Mr. Zantopoulos, who I hadn't met before, and Marina, who have done everything in the world to make us welcome, myself, my brother, and all our family here, made us felt at home like you could not believe. I was in awe of how close a family they are. So one, I'd like to thank Mr. Zantopoulos and his unbelievable wife, Marina. And I'd like to thank her. Unbelievable people, and meeting the whole family at their house was, you know, we didn't know what to expect, but Marina and her sisters did a tremendous work. I want them to stand up. All I want you to know, we were there for 2 nights, they never sat down. They kept working and smoking in the kitchen. And there are two other people where I have to mention, because before I get to the main people of the night, and I just felt I have to mention them because they have been just tremendous. George Dufus and Chris Quinn. George took the day off work the other day to play golf with us and show us how the golf game is played around Australia. And his wife had a sonogram earlier in the day, and really he didn't need to do that. He was busy, but and in the meantime, he found time, and his wife found time to let him do that, and we appreciate that.
Yes.
Stand up, George. What about your wife? Is your wife not with you? All right, come on, stand up. And to the new baby that's on its way, we hope that. And now let's get on to the main focus of the night here. Some people by the name of Dora and Nimick. And this speech was written by my wife and my daughter. had to change it on a little bit, as you see, but they have a fondness to Emmett and Dora like you cannot believe. And when I first met Dora, within 10 minutes, I realized the jewel that Emmett had. My wife and my daughter met Dora. My daughter came back and she brought that. That's the one from my uncle and me. So I'd like to say what my daughter wanted me to say tonight. She said, congratulations to Dora and Eric, and I wish you both the best. I wish you both all the best and the happiness that anybody could have. And she wanted to put in the exclamation that you have the best man that anybody could ever have. And that person happened to be my uncle Emmett. And we won't drag it on too much longer. We want to make a toast. Let's put our glasses up. To Dora and Emmett. More a joint family and a joint camaraderie than us. We'll be always there for you. We'll always be there for the Santopoulos family. And we are the luckiest people in the world.
Yeah. Once again, put your hands together, please, for Kevin. Thank you. All right. Spoken from the heart. And now, ladies and gentlemen, as you can see, our groom is saying a few words.
I'm going to keep it short and sweet, hopefully. First of all, I'd just like to welcome everybody here. Everybody who's come from Greece, New York, Ireland, and of course Melbourne. I mean, It's just so good for me and Dora to have so many people here tonight enjoying. The main thing is that everybody enjoys themselves. That's it. You know, Dora made it a prerequisite that everybody enjoys themselves. And they get home safe. That's the second thing. Right, the next thing, there's a Topless family. I cannot say, I just can't put it in words how much they have made everybody that has come here feel so welcome and so loved. It's really unbelievable. I've said it 3 or 4 times already since I've been here, but it's actually true, you know. When it's true, it comes across as being true because it's a fact. We came here, my parents met them once, and it was like they knew each other for ages, for a long time. The whole family is just unbelievable. I mean, you go in their home, and there's a lot of people, obviously, that live here, that have been in their home. You go in their home, you leave their home, you're just drained, because they give you so much. They make you just feel so welcome, respected, and good that when you leave there, you just feel like you leave and you have a great time. I mean, these are people like who just truly really good people and a really good family. I mean, some people say it sometimes, but it's not true. But this is true. This is 100%. The next person I want to talk about is Dora. I got a lot of pages about her. When Dora and I met over 2 years ago, I was just a regular, you know, regular Joe. I go to work, I work 6-7 days a week. Preferably 7, you know, because I want to make a few bucks. I can go to New York not to make a few dollars, but you know what I mean? So I usually work 6-7 days a week. Then I met Dora, she changed it all, you know what I mean? She's been so good for me. The minute I met her, I knew. I mean, we met one night, and we left to go home. I don't know if I should say this, but we left to go home, but Andy was chaperoning us, actually. And on the way home, I drove around the block, and I came back, and I said, look, listen, I'm going to hang around for another hour. So we hung around for another hour, me, Annie, and Dora. And I just thought that, what a wonderful person. I mean, I knew it straight away. So the next date we had, again, we were chaperoned by Lassie. Which is pretty tough, you know what I mean? But we went out, we hung out for a while. Lassie was there. We talked, we hung out for a little while. Lassie was there. We had a good time. And then we didn't see each other for a couple of days. I've got to say they were the longest couple of days that I was ever apart from somebody, because I knew right there and then that me and Dora would definitely be together. If it meant it up, if it meant anything to do with me, I would have to be with her, you know what I mean? And I mean, John here has got my back at most things, and he knows that Dora just changed my world up for the best, for the best, because she's a really classy person, a really loving person, a really enthusiastic person. She's tenacious, she's hard working, but she's got great ethics. She's been brought up in a great family, and you can see that straight off the bat. I mean, it's so obvious that Dora's been brought up in a great family. I mean, I knew it straight away, and I couldn't leave it go. If it was in my power to do it, you know what I mean? So I'm just so glad that me and Dora together, we got married. I mean, it's just made my world, you know, it's made everything good for me, you know? The one thing I missed was somebody like Dora, you know? She made everything happen for me. The last thing I want to say is I just want to say that I hope everybody enjoys themselves tonight. The top of this family has really worked so hard to make this night what it is. It's really a credit to the whole family. I mean, the Melbourne family, the family from Greece, it's really, you know, it's their night as much as our night. Because it's just been unbelievable. And I just hope everybody enjoys themselves, has a good night, and gets home safe. And that's it.
Come on, you can do better than that. A round of applause for the groom. You going next, Annie?
We're going to switch it up, guys. I'm going next.
Give a round of applause.
Dora was supposed to go next, but I thought I could follow because I've got more dirt on them than my letter. I was actually with them the night they met. I was doing Thank you. I'm Lassie, by the way, if nobody knows who that is. I was with them the night they met. Dora and I were playing pool. I was about to get into a big brawl with somebody until Emmett had to come and referee. That's how we met. And I won the $40, that was the bet. And he refereed for us, and that's how those two lovebirds met. Now you gotta say, that was the best night, I think, of Dora's life. I've been with Dora ever since I was a little baby. We've grown up in the same room, even though we had four bedrooms. Dora and I slept together until I was like 18, and then I think we got into a fight, and Dora had to move into the other room. And then about a week later, I followed her because I couldn't live without her. So I love Dora with all my heart. And then I met Emmett, and Emmett's like now the second brother that we have because we have George first. Love you, George. And I couldn't ask for a second brother. He's my New York brother, and I love him with all my heart. And I was with him. Yeah, I did chaperone him for about 3 weeks because Dora came, and I was like, "Oh, my dad's gonna say something happened." Because and it's like, "I'll take Dora out," and I'm like, "But Dora, we don't know who he is, and Dad would kill us." And he would kill us. So I went out with him for 3 weeks, and I said, "Emma, you know, if you really like my sister, you don't mind if I come." And then on the third week, I said, "Do you have a friend or a cousin?" And that's where John came. anyway, maybe to drag it on. But Emmett, I welcome you to our family. I love you so much. Dora, I'm so happy for you. And the Kellys, I couldn't say no. Dan, Daisy, love you guys. Kevin, Pat. Everybody that's here. Thank you very much, Dora, and I wish you the best. I will be the spokesman.
Thanks, Amy. And now I think Dora would like to say a few words. Is that correct, Dora? Yeah. The bride. All right.
I'll just say a few words in Greek. I did finish Greek school, but I hope I was listening. Sometimes I don't think I was. Anyway, πρώτα θέλω να ευχαριστήσω όλοι που ήρθαν εδώ το βράδυ. Δεύτερο θέλω να ευχαριστήσω τη μαμά και τον μπαμπά, που είναι οι πιο καλύτερες γονείς που μπορώ να ρωτήσω. Thank you. Θέλω να ευχαριστήσω όλοι που ήρθαν από την Αμερική, από την Ιρλανδία και από την Ελλάδα. Θέλω να ευχαριστήσω πάρα πολύ τη Τασία, τη Θεία Τασία και τη Θεία Ελένα που ήρθαν και το Θείο Διονύση και το Βασίλη. Η μαμά δεν τους έχει δει για, νομίζω, όχι, τους έχεις δει, αλλά δεν έχουν έρθει στην Αυστραλία για περίπου 35 χρόνια. Και είναι πάρα πολύ καιρό που η μαμά μου δεν έχει δει τις αδερφές τους εδώ στο σπίτι. Και είναι μεγάλη χαρά για τη μαμά το βράδυ να τους έχει μαζί τους στο γάμο μου. Ευχαριστώ πάρα πολύ. Θέλω να ευχαριστήσω όλοι που ήρθαν εδώ το βράδυ και είμαι πάρα πολύ χαρούμενη και ευτυχισμένη που έχω γνωρίσει τον Έμετ. Το γνώρισα περίπου 2 χρόνια και ήταν λίγο δύσκολο για μας γιατί εγώ έμενα εδώ και αυτός εμείς στην Αμερική. Αλλά από την πρώτη στιγμή που τον γνώρισα, ήξερα αμέσως ότι ήταν το παιδί για μένα. Ήμουνα 32 χρονών και ο μπαμπάς μου έλεγε, «Πότε θα παντρευτείς, τι θα κάνουμε με εσένα, ο μπαμπάς μου έχει παντρευτεί, θα πάει με τον Τζος, θα κάνουμε νερό, έχουμε την Άννη και την Χριστίνα, πότε θα γίνει κάτι με εσένα». Και τώρα, ας είναι εδώ, κάτι θα γίνει για μένα. I'll explain all this in English as well. Και γύρισα από την Αμερική και δεν είπα τίποτα στο μπαμπά για περίπου 6 μήνες και λέω, θα δούμε τι θα γίνει πρώτα. Και ένα βράδυ λέω, ο μπαμπά, έχω γνωρίσει ένα παιδί. Α, very good. Και μου λέει, και πώς το λένε, και το λένε
Emmett, και ποιο όνομα είναι αυτό. Και το λέω, είναι από την Ιρλανδία. Εδώ ή από εκεί, όχι από την Αμερική. Πώς είναι από την Αμερική, αφού είναι από την Ιρλανδία και εσύ είσαι εδώ. Και το λέω, long story, κάτι θα σου πω ένα βράδυ. Και τον είπα ότι θέλω να πάω στην Αμερική για 3 μήνες να γνωρίσω ένα παιδί που ξέρω. Θέλω να είμαι με την αδελφή μου και με το παιδί να δω αν έχω μια ζωή μαζί του. Και λέω, δεν ξέρω αν θα πάνε καλά ή άσχημα τα πράγματα, αλλά πρέπει να πάω να δω. Πήγα εκεί και τον λέω, ό,τι γίνει, παπά, θα ξαναγυρίσω στο σπίτι. Και ξαναγύρισα και λέω, παπά, τα Χριστούγεννα θα έρθει το παιδί να σου ρωτήσει, να νομίζω ότι θα παντρευτούμε μαζί. Και μου λέει, όχ, ωραία. Οκ, very good, πάλι μου λέει. Τα Χριστούγεννα ήρθε ο Έμερ με μια βαλίτσα στο χέρι. Ήρθε στο σπίτι του πατέρα μου, χωρίς να τον γνωρίσει. Έφερε και το δαχτυλίδι στη τσέπη του. Και τον πήρα από τον αεροδρόμιο με την Άννη και μου λέει, είσαι σίγουρη ότι ο πατέρας σου θέλει να με γνωρίσει? Και λέω, ναι. Ήρθε στο σπίτι με τα δώρα και ο μπαμπάς με το ωραίο κουστούμι και την κραβάτα του. Και μου λέει, φαίνεται ωραία, φαίνεσαι λεβέντη, μπαμπά. Και ανοίγει την πόρτα και μου λέει, Emmett, welcome στην οικογένεια μας. Χωρίς να του μιλήσει μια λέξη. Και από τότε κατάλαβα ότι ο Έμε και ο πατέρας μου θα γίνουν μαζί σε μια οικογένεια.
Δεμένοι
μαζί. Thanks, Lassie. Σου είπα, δεν ξέρω όλα τα ελληνικά. Από εκείνο το βράδυ, ο πατέρας μου με τον Έμε μιλήσανε. Ο πατέρας μου τον πήγε κάτω. Ξέρεις που έχουμε κάτω τη φωτιά. Και λέει, έλα να μιλήσουμε προσωπικά εγώ και εσένα. Τώρα τι έχεις στην τράπεζα, τι γίνεται με το σπίτι, τι κάνεις, δεν ξέρω για την κόρη μου. Αλλά ξέρεις κάτι, όταν το άκουσα, όχι βαβά, μην το κάνεις. Αλλά κατάλαβα ότι ήταν το πιο καλύτερο πράγμα. Γιατί κατάλαβα τότε ότι ο πατέρας μου με αγαπάει πάρα πολύ. Και εγώ τώρα θα πάω να μείνω σε μια άλλη χώρα. Και ο πατέρας μου ήθελε να ξέρει πού θα με πάει αυτό το παιδί. Πού θα μείνω, τι σπίτι θα μείνω, τι φαγητό θα πάω και τι θα κάνω. Και σε ευχαριστώ πάρα πολύ, μπαμπά, που είχες αυτό το τρόπο και το βράδυ. Σε ευχαριστώ πάρα πολύ. Τελευταία, ήθελα να ευχαριστήσω τη μάνα και τον πατέρα μου που με έχουν μεγαλώσει στη γυναίκα που είμαι τώρα. Ελπίζω έχω κάνει μια καλή δουλειά και για σας. Μεθαύριο θα φύγω να πάω να μείνω στην Αμερική. Δεν ξέρω τι δρόμο θα με φέρει αύριο όταν πάω εκεί. Αλλά έχω πρώτα ένα καλό άντρα τώρα, Emmett. Έχω και δεύτερη μια αδερφή που αγαπάω πάρα πολύ. Θα αφήσω και 2 αδερφές εδώ στη Μελβούνη που θα μου λείπουν πάρα πολύ. Αλλά θα κάνω ό,τι έκανε και η μάνα μου. Ήρθε στην Αυστραλία μόνη της και έχει 6 αδερφές στην Ελλάδα. Ήρθε μόνη της και δεν ήξερε και το πατέρα μου για πολύ καιρό, μόνο για 4 μήνες. Αλλά έχει κάνει μια καλή ζωή, ευτυχισμένη ζωή. Και ελπίζω και εγώ να κάνω το ίδιο στην Αμερική. Μια μέρα νομίζω θα γυρίσω και εγώ εδώ, δεν ξέρω πότε. Αλλά ελπίζω να έχω την ίδια τύχη ότι και την αγάπη που έχουν η μαμά και ο μπαμπά μου το βράδυ. Words in Australian. First of all, thank you obviously everyone for coming here this evening. Everyone looks very nice. The place is great. I want to thank the land for doing such a great job this evening. And the band, Jose. Thank you, Emmanuel. You guys have done a great job. The only thing I really want to talk about is Emmett tonight. Let's get to the point. New York style. Babe, I met Emmett in Queens, down Ditmars Boulevard at an Irish pub called McCann's. Had no idea that he was going to be there, obviously. Annie and I were going there for a couple of quiet drinks with a couple of her co-workers, and we walked straight to the back and we played a couple of games of pool. And I saw this guy with a New York Yankees cap, even though I'm a Red Sox fan, but anyway, that's another story. And I just saw him and I was just like, I just lost it, and I got any kind of rescue. Dora, get back to the game. We've got jobs to do tonight. So I started looking at him, and then 5 minutes later, I couldn't help myself. I walked straight up to him and I said, look, can you come over and referee our game? We've got a few problems. My sister's being a bit of a ball breaker over there. So he comes straight over and he goes, oh, what's that accent? I go, Australian. And he goes, what's your name? And I said, Dora. And he goes, are you married? I said, no. He goes, have you got any kids? I said, no. That was the first 3 questions he asked me. And he's like, oh, very good, very good. And then we chatted all night, and then we went home, he gave his phone number, and as soon as I got home, I was like stressed out. And I said, Annie, give me your cell phone. And I rang him, and he came straight around the block, picked us up, and we stayed out and we went for a couple more drinks. The next day, Annie and I already planned to go to Vegas. So we were gone for 5 days. And as soon as I got back, it was my birthday. And he came over with something I can't mention, with a flower. And we had a great night. 10 days later, it was Emma's birthday. And almost every night we saw each other. Until Annie goes, which Annie sort of started saying the story, she goes, listen, Dora, you guys can't keep doing this. I can't keep being the third wheel on your date. So I said, Emma, bring a friend, and he's very fussy, she wants someone good looking. Bring someone. So Emma goes, I don't know what to do. I go, bring someone, otherwise we can't see each other. I really can't just see my sister. So Emma's on the phone, doof, doof, doof. The first call was John, his second cousin. Brings John to the same pub that we met. 10 minutes later, they were in the corner. And then he comes up to you, she goes, and I'll say in drink. Okay, I can't get it to him now. Anyway, here we are tonight, 2 years later, and those two are together as well. Thank you very much. Thank you everyone for coming. Have a great night, and I'll talk to you again.
Thanks, Dora. Come on, another round of applause for Dora. And now, ladies and gentlemen, we have the bride's father to say a few words.
Bless from your Lord, these daughters, que se pori pa pediam, que se la pediam pa pa sama kusuna pop se pune ne. Καλησπέρα σας. Η πείρα της ζωής μου με έχει διδάξει το εξής. Όσα πιο λιγότερα λες, τόσο πιο περισσότερα μένουν σε αυτούς που σ' ακούνε, μένουν στο μυαλό τους. Αλλά εδώ η κόρη μου τράβηξε μεγάλο δρόμο και μέσα στη ζωή υπάρχουν εξαιρέσεις και ίσως σε αυτή την εξαίρεση θα μου επιτρέψετε να επεκταθώ λίγο πιο μακριά. Σας εκ μέρους μου και ολόκληρη της οικογένειάς μου και της συζύγου μου Μαρίνας σας καλωσορίζω όλους σας και σας ευχαριστώ όλους σας που ήρθατε απόψε με την παρουσία σας να εκφράσετε την ευτυχία για τα παιδιά μας. Είναι μεγάλη η βραδιά για μας τους γονείς και όσοι έχετε περάσει αυτή τη βραδιά θα με αισθάνεστε πώς ακριβώς αισθάνομαι. Θέλω να κάνω μια παρένθεση, αν μου επιτρέπετε. Όλοι οι γονείς, αλλά ιδιαίτερα εμείς οι γονείς του εξωτερικού, έχουμε πάθει μια ψυχολογική αρρώστια με τα παιδιά μας. Ό,τι εμείς έχουμε στηρεθεί στην δική μας ηλικία, στην εφηβική μας ηλικία, από γνωστές συνθήκες που γνωρίζετε, προσπαθούμε εμείς ό,τι στηρεθήκαμε να το δώσουμε στα παιδιά μας. Ίσως το αποδίδω αυτό σε 2 αιτίες. Μία αιτία είναι, εφόσον εμείς συστηρηθήκαμε, προσπαθούμε να δώσουμε ό,τι και δεν έχουμε για να ευχαριστήσουμε το μέλλον του παιδιού μας. Η δεύτερη αιτία είναι, ίσως, επειδή είναι το πιο κοινωνικό, το πιο περιβάλλον που ερχόμαστε συνέχεια σε επικοινωνία. Τα παιδιά μας είναι η γειτόνι μας, το χωριό μας, η πατρίδα μας. Και εκεί έχουμε πάθει μια ψυχολογική ψυχοσύνθεση για τα παιδιά μας. Δηλαδή, όχι ότι το εκμεταλλεύονται, αλλά ίσως εμείς οι ίδιοι οι γονείς έχουμε αρρωστήσει πού είναι το παιδί μας, πώς θα περάσει το παιδί μας, και παντρεμένο είναι και ανύπατρο, δεν πάβουμε ποτέ να είμαστε δίπλα στο πλευρό του. Ελπίζω εδώ η Δώρα μου να έκανε μια καλή εκλογή με τον άνθρωπο που διάλεξε για να πάει. Κάνει λίγο εξφρανίσεις στον άντρα σου. Τράβηξε μακρινό δρόμο, άνοιξε τα φτερά της και σαν χελιδόνι έφυγε στην πιο απομακρυσμένη χώρα της γυραιάς Ευρώπης, σε μια χώρα που είναι στολισμένη με τα λουλούδια, στην Ιρλανδία. Ουδέποτε πέρασε από το μυαλό μου ότι θα κάνω συμπεθέρους από την Ιρλανδία. Αλλά κάθισα και σκέφτηκα ότι με την καινούργια τεχνολογία που υπάρχει, όλος ο κόσμος δίπλα μας έχει γίνει ένα χωριό. Και όλοι οι άνθρωποι είναι γειτόνιοι. Αλλά η Δώρα μου δεν με κάθισε ούτε εκεί. Πάλι πήγε σε μια καινούργια Ήπειρος, στην Αμερική, σε μια πόλη που είναι και πολλοί Έλληνες εκεί, όπως είναι και εδώ στη Μελβούρνη. Για λίγο εκάθισα και σκέφτηκα. Και τι ήρθε στη σκέψη μου. Από την αρχαιότατη εποχή, εμείς οι Έλληνες είμαστε μεταναστευτικός λαός. Ίσως φεύγουμε για ένα καλύτερο επίπεδο, αλλά ίσως και ο βαθύτερος σκοπός που μεταναστεύουμε, ίσως να αφήνουμε τα αχνάρια του ελληνικού πολιτισμού. Το ίδιο ίσως επιτελούμε και εδώ στην Αυστραλία. Η γλώσσα της ιστορίας θα γράψει πάρα πολλά για τον ελληνισμό της Αυστραλίας και ιδιαίτερα για τις Μελβούρνης. Επιτελούμε εμείς ένα σπουδαίο καθήκον οι Έλληνες εδώ που διαβιούμε σε αυτή τη χώρα. Δεν είναι μόνο η διαβίωση, η καλύτερη διαβίωση της ζωής, αλλά είναι και ο εκπολιτισμός τον οποίο σκορπίζουμε σε αυτή τη χώρα. Η Δώρα μου έφυγε πολύ μακριά, αλλά με τις καινούργιες τεχνολογίες που υπάρχουν δεν νομίζω ότι οι αποστάσεις είναι τόσο μακριά, αλλά έχουν εκμεδυνιστεί. Εύχομαι στη Δώρα το εξής και θέλω να το βάλει βαθιά στο μυαλό της, ότι στη ζωή της η ζωή δεν είναι τόσο εύκολη, δεν είναι φρουφρού και αρώματα, δεν είναι όλο λουλούδια. Θα έχει ζωή και μεγάλες τρικυμίες, θα έχει στενοχώριες, θα έχει προβλήματα. Αλλά βάλτε στο μυαλό σου αυτό που θα σου λέει ο πατέρας σου. Όταν είσαι οργισμένη, όταν είσαι θυμωμένη, μη θελήσεις να λύσεις τα προβλήματα αυτή τη στιγμή, διότι δεν θα μπορέσεις να βρεις λύση. Ο οργισμένος, ο θυμωμένος και ο μεθυσμένος ουδέποτε λύνουν προβλήματα, αλλά δημιουργούν προβλήματα. Άσε το χρόνο, ο οποίος είναι ο μεγαλύτερος σύμβουλος, ο μεγαλύτερος γιατρός, ο οποίος θα σε συμβουλεύσει την άλλη μέρα ποιο είναι το καλύτερο να κάνεις, γιατί θα έχεις καθαρό το μυαλό σου. Εν άλλο να σου πω, η αγάπη είναι ωραίο πράγμα, είναι ένα στολίδι στους νέους, όπως και εμείς περάσαμε. Αλλά παρέλαση του χρόνου, τα πράγματα αλλάζουν. Τι μένει στον άνθρωπο, ο χαρακτήρας, ο σεβασμός. Άμα εσύ κάνεις respect, σέβεσαι τον άντρα σου και αυτός θα σεβαστεί. Και το πιο σπουδαιότερο, θα κάνεις και καμία ωραία οικογένεια που θα πάρει το δείγμα από τους γονείς του. Ένα πράγμα θέλω να σου πω. Μέσα στις φλέβες σου ρέει ελληνικό αίμα και δεν θέλω ποτέ να μπορέσεις να αφομοιωθείς, να αγγλοξοποιηθείς. Πάντοτε να κρατήσεις την ταυτότητά σου. Αυτό είναι το πιο ωραιότερο πράγμα στη ζωή σου. Όταν φτάσεις σε ένα σημείο που θα θέλει να στολίσει στο σπίτι σου, το σαλόνι σου. Δεν θέλω να βάλεις και μια ωραία φωτογραφία, την φωτογραφία του Παρθενώνα, διότι ακτινοβολεί και στολίζει ολόκληρο τον κόσμο. Μια ωραία τραγουδίστρια, η Βέμπο, στο Δεύτερο Παγκόσμιο Πόλεμο, είχε πει το εξής: όλο τον κόσμο να γυρίσετε, δεν θα βρείτε δύο πράγματα, Ρετσίνα και Παρθενώνα. Λοιπόν, κράτησε μέσα στη ζωή σου αυτά που σε δίδαξαν, Δώρα, κράτησε μέσα στη ζωή σου αυτά που σε δίδαξαν οι γονείς σου. Προσπάθησε να ακολουθήσεις τα παιδιά σου κάτω από τον ελληνικό ορθόδοξο πολιτισμό μας και πάντοτε θα αισθάνεσαι περηφάνεια σε αυτό το πράγμα. Και εγώ, τη μάνα σου, τη μεγαλύτερη ευχή που μπορούμε να σου δώσουμε είναι μόνο η ευχή μας που να γίνει το φυλακτό, το κλειδί της ευτυχίας της ζωής σου. Οι ευχή γονέων στερίζουν θεμέλια οίκων. Πάντοτε να κρατήσεις τον εαυτό σου ψηλά σαν Ελληνίδα που μέσα σου ρέει το ελληνικό αίμα. Ευχαριστώ πάρα πολύ και ο Θεός να είναι μαζί σου. I want to talk a few words in English to understand me. I've never been in school for one day, but I'll do it. Dear Daniel and Tazi, welcome in Australia, welcome on my home. I feel very proud for my daughter to marry your son, Emmett. Reason why I feel very proud, because Emmett has come from good father and good mother. He's working very and working very hard all his life to give the best education, to make a good character, to give the best manners, to make a nice person for the society. I believe Emmett he been one nice person, and the time can tell to us. I know Emmett for short time, but in futures he can tell to me to be a same person like George Dufas, because George has come for excellent family. Emmett, you no marry only Dora. You marry Greek customers too. You put this deeply on your brain and not try never not to respect the Dora with the Greek customers. And I believe Dora to respect you again with your customers. This is making very good family. Thank you very much to come all here. Before going, I want to say another few words. Thank you very much. The sisters of my lovely wife has come here. Όλους σας που ήρθατε από την Ελλάδα, ευχαριστώ πάρα πολύ και ορισμένοι που ήρθαν από τα άλλα site της Αυστραλίας, σας ευχαριστώ πολύ, τη Λένα, τη Δασία, το Διονύση, το Βασίλη, ευχαριστώ πάρα πολύ για όλους σας. Και πριν τελειώσω την ομιλία μου, θέλω να ευχαριστήσω την παλιά φρουρά, τους παλιούς μου φίλους, τους παλιούς μου κουμπάρους, που έχω ζήσει μαζί τους και χαρές και πίκρες και έχουν σταθεί πάντοτε στις ωραίτερες χαρές της ζωής μου. Τι μπορώ δώρο να τους δώσω εγώ σε αυτούς, μόνο να τους ευχηθώ στο Θεό μακροζωία και στο κατόφλι του σπιτιού τους, στην πόρτα του σπιτιού τους, να χαρίζεται, να περπατάει η ευτυχία και στα παιδιά τους και στα γόνια τους και σε όλους εμάς. Και πάντοτε εμείς οι Έλληνες όπου και να βρισκόμεστε, δεν θα ξεχάσουμε τα ωραία δανεικά της πατρίδας μας, γιατί είναι τα καλύτερα του κόσμου. Ευχαριστώ πολύ, πάρα πολύ. Να είστε καλά. Ladies and gentlemen, once again, please put your hands together for peace. Very shortly, the fun begins. We have some great traditional dancing.
Thank you. scheduled fare. This is what you call Greek aerobics.
Κάτι από εδώ και από την Ελλάδα. Μόνο έχουμε μισή ώρα και το μπέντερ να χορέψουμε λίγο ακόμα. Θα ήθελα να ευχαριστήσω όλους που έχουν στείλει κάτι. Συγγνώμη που δεν μπορώ να το διαβάσω το βράδυ, αλλά θα το διαβάσω αύριο και θα σας πάρω όλο ιδιαίτερη τηλέφωνο να σας πω ευχαριστώ πάρα πολύ για τα ωραία δώρα που μας έχετε στείλει. Και ο Έμετε να πει ένα κάτι λίγο γρήγορα. Όχι στα ελληνικά, μόνο στα αγγλέζικα.
And also, we'd just like to thank everybody who's given cards and various gifts over the last week or so. We deeply appreciate it. And just thank you so much. And listen, everybody should get on the dance floor. Stop the shenanigans. Stop the coffee. Drop the glasses down and get on the floor, you know what I mean? There's a big floor here. What are you doing? Excellent. All right. Thank you for coming.
And το τελευταίο πράγμα θέλω να ευχαριστήσω τη μαμά και τον παπά για όλη τη σκληρή και δύσκολη δουλειά που έχουν κάνει όχι μόνο το βράδυ, για όλη τη ζωή μου. Θέλω να σας ευχαριστήσω πάρα πολύ. Σας αγαπώ πάρα πολύ και ελπίζω να σας μοιάσω μια μέρα όπως εσείς σήμερα. Ευχαριστώ πάρα πολύ. Thank you.
Better than ever. Nothing feels the same.
happy weekend. Thank you.
One and two and three. Congratulations to Andrea. Yeah? All the best. Gentlemen.
Sin me daga,
σήμερα γάμος γίνεται. Το ωραίο περιβόλι, στο ωραίο περιβόλι, στο ωραίο περιβόλι, στο ωραίο περιβόλι.
I'm going to Germany.
Whatever, the grace.
Bye-bye.